Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Step A-Frame. This is a 150 square foot tiny cabin, just a 2 hour drive away from New York City. I think it is the perfect couples getaway. There's a bunch of amazing amenities both inside and out to keep you entertained throughout your entire stay. And this is an off-grid Airbnb, so it allows you to truly disconnect for a couple of nights. So without further ado, let's now go and start the full tour. Welcome to the Step A-Frame. This is one of the cutest little cabins I've ever come across throughout my travels. We are located in Montgomery, New York today. It's time for a full tour. Starting on the front deck, you have these two comfy white chairs. And as we zoom out now with the drone, you can see there's a lot to explore on the exterior. Continuing on, we're gonna go to your lovely fire pit setup, and I'm now going to very aggressively break up the kindling. They left a bunch of wood and fire starter supplies inside of this little tin garbage can, which I'm doing such an incredibly lovely presentation for you. There's a bunch of fire starters, and it's very easy to get this up and going. This is one of those really sweet Brio fire pits. It's a smokeless fire pit, and it's just super simple to make a fire and keep a fire going. After relaxing around the fire pits, we're now going to zoom out and go to the other side of the property. You can actually play cornhole here. It's a lot of fun, but definitely best played with someone else. I was playing by myself. We'll go closer to the cabin now because there's this really fun space to the right. You have this giant Jenga game. I play this a lot over the summer with friends, and this can be so much fun and go on for quite a bit of time if you and the person you're playing against are any good. But now behind the Jenga game, you have this nice little grill set up. This is just the perfect barbecue and hangout space located right next to the cabin. Finally, before we head inside, I'll briefly mention the surrounding area. We're on a private section on 78 acres on a still active farm. I think it's the perfect escape for any of my New Yorkers who want to come out for a weekend. But that's it for everything on the exterior, so I'm now finally going to walk up the little deck and open up this front door, but it's time to check out the incredibly cozy interior. Welcome inside to the Step A-Frame. As a reminder, the interior is about just 150 square feet total. So yes, quite small, a bit of a micro tiny cabin, but it's absolutely jam-packed with a ton of amenities. Some of the best amenities I've ever seen in a tiny home before. And we're now gonna unpack every different corner, every different section of this main room. Let's begin first with the bed area because it's the first thing you see as soon as you walk in and definitely the centerpiece. Above the bed though, you have some cool lighting fixtures, and this is a bit of a bird's eye view of that area because I was standing up really tall to get this shot. In terms of details for this area, if you look down beneath this bench next to the bed, there's a few key items waiting for you. So I'm gonna grab them now, and they include this big roll of toilet paper and some cleaning wipes. There's also this game, and next to that, you have two towels that you can use throughout your stay. We'll move further into the bed area now. I really loved all these color combos, like the dark green paint and all of that wood paneling. But now we'll focus our attention on these two little tables on either side of the bed. First up, you have this white sign here because the host partnered with a local coffee shop. You can get some free coffee if you bring down a mug. There's also a couple plates here if you want to do some cooking. On the other side of the bed, you have this charming sign, some lighting fixtures, and another table which has some flowers and a little clock on top of it. But one of the sweetest parts of this entire area is this really nice welcome tray that the host left for you. There's a bunch of nice goodies. I'll start first with this card that the hosts Evan and Courtney left for me. It was a handwritten note and personal, which is always greatly appreciated. On top of that, there is this nice bottle of white wine and also a separate bottle of water. Some very nice touches by the hosts. I'll walk in this direction now back towards the front door because you can pull this curtain across the door for some extra privacy, but there's really no one out here. It's extremely private, I promise. Let's now focus on some other corners of the home. So if I take the camera and pan more to the right, we're gonna walk into this corner. Over here, you have a heater and your air conditioning, all powered by your gas generator, which I'll show a little bit later. There's also some hangers over here next to the plant and a battery-operated lantern just in case, so you'll always have some light. I'll now shift our attention there next to the front door. You have this little table in what I would probably call the welcome area. You have this big sign that says welcome to the step. If you look first though down below, you have these two baskets which I can pull out now. One is used more for storage and the other one has some extra blankets if you need them when it gets colder out. I'll put the baskets away and now I'll look up to on top of the table because there's a few nice things that I definitely want to point out for you. On the right side, there's some more information on the step and check-in and check-out procedures. The host also wrote quite a bit about themselves, their story, why they decided to build this Airbnb. One of the coolest features though is this Polaroid camera that is left behind. So if you're staying here, you can take a picture of you and your significant other or the other guests, and it makes for a really beautiful guest book. This looks lovely. One of the final spots now is your sitting area. There are a couple of baskets down below which contain some essential cooking supplies like some pots and pans. There's even a hot plate here. So if you need to do some basic cooking during your stay, you can do that. There's another basket which has a bunch of games in it. So between all of the exterior amenities like your fire pit, cornhole, Jenga, and more, and everything inside here, including games like Exploding Kittens, Love Lingual, and Codenames Duet, I think you have a ton of entertainment options. Last but certainly not least, you have this gigantic Scrabble board on top of the table. It's so much fun to play, so go and grab your significant other, your boyfriend, girlfriend, wife, husband, or just clone yourself like me and play against yourself. So much fun. Well, that's about it for everything inside. I want to just close on two more quick things. One very key item is your gas generator. Again, this is an off-grid Airbnb, but this generator is quite easy to operate. They left behind some detailed instructions, and it was pretty powerful. I was able to both charge some drone batteries while also powering the home. You can see it there in the left-hand corner. Finally, I'm sure you're wondering, Mike, where do I go to the bathroom? Of course, I'm going to answer that. Just a 20-second walk from the home. You have this cute little outhouse waiting for you. So if I walk to this end and open up this door, we can take a peek inside. And it's very nicely decorated, especially for an outhouse. It has all these little art pieces everywhere, little mirrors, and it even has some nice string lights up top. I mean, heck, even the toilet looks really pretty and it has some flowers next to it. So in terms of an outhouse, which is sometimes pretty tough to make it look nice, I was actually quite impressed by this little outhouse at the step. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.